Die Eiterkalaut-Show by your Princess Silke.
You can tell, COINTELL, my click has never failed. My boat has never sunk, my ship has never sailed. My hope is never shaken, my spirit is never broken. My legs are never open, my words will always be quoted. My vision is focused, tell the POTUS I don't trust him, he'll never be noticed. I think it's time that I put you all on notice. I'm the one, David Ruffin, I'll never be Otis. If I did it, then it better work. The music industry hates me cause I'll never twerk. I'm in a different world, each verse brings the metaverse. Optometrist, I change vision like the Oculus. Watch me fly over metropolis. Tell all the populace, rise from sarcophagus. No hypothesis, I see apocalypse. Muhammad's disciple speaks like a prophetess. We got him light. We got him light, yeah.
Ciao, Princess Silke here. Now I'm just gonna continue talking from my previous video. Yeah, I'm intelligent and observative, naive, yes, kind, but nobody se pasa de lanza conmigo. Ha! Help me translate. No one is gonna pass my boundaries. No one ever did. Alright. So, who is El Dickman? He was, what? He was the right hand, immediately subject of the Secretary of Gobernación, which was a subsecretary at the time. There were not very many at the time. I noticed that they split them. It was a subsecretary from, it doesn't matter. Okay, what does Secretaría de Gobernación does? Okay, well, it's Secretary of Relaciones Exteriores, External Relationship. Gobernación is the one who issues all the permits and visas for foreigners. Not education, not transports, not phone companies, no. Foreigners, permits. So Elik had the power in his hand. Often, he could give out permits. He could also deny them. And that's power. He told me. I mentioned it in my book. Yeah, I think he was threatening me, but I wasn't really sure. Because at the time I wasn't expecting any passive aggressiveness or any meaning behind the words or tone of voice changes. I did not understand any of that, that it even exist. So, no, I was just had to get up. I saw a little buggy. And I'm so weak right now. So I did not understand it, but he told me, we have a million spies in Mexico City alone. And with one phone call, I can send anybody, any foreigner out of the country, deport them. Wow. Oh, the spies are people like, well, the one thing I can think about are store owners. Business owners who were right there, like the person from the newspaper, just observed the streets. He got an extra salary or something by being a spy, just like that. That was an important piece of information which he shouldn't have been revealing to me, because that was actually state secret. But that's okay, because how else could I tell you guys, right, my people? Oh, we crossed the border. An airplane. I did have my passport. In a tiny little plane, once. We drove back in car. Oh, shopping. Yeah, shopping in some outlet, man. Yeah, it sounds. For Mexico, that's exciting. What's that Costco? Something. No, I'm not joking. But we cross the border like anything. It's like anybody can actually cross the border with certain connections. Oh, I also crossed the security and the airport with him. I didn't have to pass security when I boarded an airplane. He walked me right into the airplane. I could have had anything on my back. The point is not that I have anything. The point is that it's possible. Oh yes, anything we did, he always said, "Oh Silkita, please." He asked me, he begged me to come upon Benahim because he had some important business. I think it was just enveloped to get me over any place. Right now. Yeah, and to Paris, he brought his dumb friend, the one I explained the previous video. Because he couldn't go alone, he was too shivery, frightened. Our almost, you know, subsecretary, almost. But what I saw is that when we went to places, we went to eat. And the people who would attend us, the owners, would be so submissive. I had not checked that was much later, that they were all foreigners. And that he had something to do with the permits. At the time, I had no idea. I was just looking how friendly they were, and Alik would always say, "My friend, here is my friend, blah, blah, and my friend." What a cynical way, man. I don't know, that probably paid, you know, monthly fees to Alik. Submissive and frightened. Yeah, who? A Bolivian in Cuernavaca, a Chinaman in Mexico City. I can't think about more right now. But yes, it summed up. Totally illegal, but what are you gonna do? There's no police in Mexico who protects you. Was the food good? No. No, I'm thinking, why am I telling the story? Oh yes, and then we went to Mexicali to visit his friend. Yeah, the one and only. The dubious person I explained in the previous one. And he had an amazing yacht. I don't know if it was amazing. Depends on what you deemed amazing, but it was new. No, it wasn't that large, but yes, enough. A few people on board, I have no clue who that was. So maybe that's when I thought, how can this person, he dressed also very clean, like new clothing had he on. See, outside, he looked like a perfect, I don't know, what could it be? Not like an accountant, but something was off. I didn't ask questions. I wasn't supposed to from my higher perspective. Because if I would have sniffed any illegal business or any crocodile, I would not have seen anything. I would not have met Alik. Ever. Or if I would have met him and I knew that this guy is like horrible, I would have gotten up at the table. No, I have dignity and a healthy pride. But I must have perhaps needed to hang in there for a few years to observe all this croqueterias.
There must have been an